The shadow scales are all but forgotten. An ancient tradition from another time.
Are we alone?
Yes.
Yes! Alone! Sweet solitude! No one will hear us, disturb us. Everything is going according to plan. The others, I've spoken to them, and they're coming around, I know it. The wizard Festus Crex. Perhaps even the Argonian and the Unchild. What about you? Have you spoken to anyone? No? No, of course not. I do the talking, the stalking, the seeing, and the saying. And what do you do? Nothing! Not that I'm angry. Oh, never. Cicero understands. Cicero always understands. And obeys. You will talk when you're ready, won't you? Won't you? Sweet night, mother.
Poor Cicero. Dear Cicero. Such a humble servant. But he will never hear my voice, for he is not the listener.
Oh, but how can I defend you? How can I exert your will if you will not speak to anyone?
Oh, but I will speak. I will speak to you, for you are the one. You who shares my iron tomb, who warms my ancient bones, I give you this task. Journey to Wallenrode. Speak with Armand Moutier.
Poor Cicero has failed you. Poor Cicero is sorry, sweet mother. I've tried so very hard, but I just can't find the listener.
Tell Cicero the time has come. Tell him the words he has been waiting for all these years. Darkness rises when silence dies.
What? What treachery? Defiler! Debaser and defiler! You have violated the sanctity of the Night Mother's coffin! Explain yourself! Speak, worm! She spoke to you? More treachery! More trickery and deceit! You lie! The Night Mother speaks only to the listener! And there is no listener! She said that. She said those words. To you. Darkness rises when silence dies. But those are the words. The binding words. Written in the keeping tomes. The signal so I would know. Mother's only way of talking to sweet Cicero. Then, it's true. She's back. Our Lady is back. She has chosen a listener. She has chosen you. All hail the listener.
By Sithis, this ends now. Back away, fool. Whatever you've been planning is over.
Are you all right? I heard the commotion. Who was Cicero talking to? Where's the accomplice?
Reveal yourself, traitor.
Oh, I spoke only to the Night Mother. I spoke to the Night Mother, but she didn't speak to me. Oh, no. She spoke only to her. To the listener.
What? The listener? What are you going on about? What is this lunacy?
It's true! It's true! The Night Mother has spoken! The silence has been broken! The listener has been chosen!
When I heard Cicero screaming, I knew you'd been discovered. I feared the worst. Are you all right? Then what in Sithis' name is going on? Cicero spoke to the Night Mother, but she spoke to you. Is this just more of the fool's rambling? What? So Cicero wasn't talking to anyone else. Just the Night Mother's body? And the Night Mother, who, according to everything we know, will only speak to the person chosen as listener, just spoke. Right now. To you? By Sithis. And? What did she say? Amand Motier? I have no idea who that is. But Valenrud. That I have heard of. And I know where it is. No. No! Listen, I don't know what's going on here, but you take your orders from me. Are we clear on that? The Night Mother may have spoken to you, but I am still the leader of this family. I will not have my authority so easily dismissed. I need time to think about all this. Go see Nazir. Do some work for him. I'll find you when I'm ready to discuss the matter further.
You are the listener! I have served Mother well, I have! The listener, well, listens. The Night Mother speaks to you, guides you on. But when the Night Mother speaks, the listener must obey. You must, for her word is the will of Sithis, and Sithis is the Dark Brotherhood incarnate. Are you excited? Oh. You should be! Things are finally looking up!
Sister. Kill well and often.
shadow scales are all but forgotten. An ancient tradition from another time.
Sister, look, if you're trying to get to know me, don't. I don't like you, and I never will. It's nothing personal, but my wife trusts you, and I trust her judgment. So you can't be... Here's all you need to know. I'm a werewolf. I like killing things. I love Astrid. I hate annoying people. And the color blue gives me a headache.
Until next time, sister.
Need something? In the Dark Brotherhood, I found it. Acceptance, love, and my life's true purpose.
Neat. So many contracts. I'll teach you how to use it effectively and keep you quick on your feet. Still here. Matter. Can't handle what I'm throwing your way. So many contracts, so little time. I don't like mimes, minstrels, thespians, acrobats, jugglers, troubadours, or tumblers. Flutists give me a headache. I particularly hate jesters. As a rule, I'm also not crazy about the corpses of old women. For the Night Mother, I'll make an exception. But Astrid is the only mistress I serve. Well then, your timing couldn't be better. As it turns out, I've got two new contracts. One rather easy assignment, and another that should prove quite a challenge. Your first target is an orc bard named Lerbuk. The other is a vampire by the name of Hearn. Happy hunting. He is, by all accounts, the worst bard in all of Skyrim. Apparently, so many people sought his death, Astrid had to hold a lottery to determine the client. He's a vampire, and has blended into human society for years. He's never far from his female companion, Hurt, also a vampire. The contract is for the male, Hearn, but you'll probably have to contend with the female, too. So for Sithis's sake, watch yourself. You've got people to kill, my friend. Best... Get to it.
It's been quite a boon, looking like a child. No one... My targets make the mistake of not perceiving me as a threat. Last mistake they ever make. Right then.
Please, not now. You'll know when I'm ready to discuss the issue.
You're not supposed to be in here.
We're here to teach you a lesson.
Hey!
Is there someone there?
Somebody help!
Thank you.
I love a challenge. Let's see what you've got. I can't.
No!